Hi. I graduated from this university in 1993. And since then, I came back maybe occasionally for a few diplomas, but I never came to make a presentation or a speech to you. So thank you, Mustafa, for this opportunity, for creating this opportunity after 22 years. And it's a pleasure to share my 22 years with you in 15 minutes. So, in order to achieve that, I have compressed my 22 years into 10 tips, which I'm calling the 10 creative commandments. The first thing I learned in ALBA was to master the designs, the shapes, and of course typography was at the center of it. Unfortunately, today this generation is speaking a different alphabet, which is emojis. So I'm going to make my presentation a little bit interactive. Each commandment is going to start with an emoji and try to guess what the commandment is about. So this is the first commandment. Any idea? It's be yourself. Okay? So what I mean by be yourself is definitely once you join an agency, you have to be humble, to be genuine. And be humble meaning that you need to know your capabilities. But most importantly, be yourself means always fight for the ideas you believe in. Okay, never go to a compromise. I'm going to share with you a few examples that will explain a little bit of background for each commandment. The following example is an ad done by BBDO Germany that the client never accepted as a script. The agency believed so much in this ad that they went and they did it, and they actually destroyed 3 cars in the making. So it cost them a lot, but they kept believing in the idea. They went back to the client and they showed him the ad. He kept being stubborn and he refused to run. So they went and they sold it to the same brand, but another market, and they loved it. This ad won a gold in Carolinas in 2014. Because at the end of the day, your client is not the person who is handling the brand, it's the brand itself. I'm going to share with you an ad that most of you are familiar with. When I presented this idea, there was a lot of resistance. The client was a little bit afraid to go with this idea. I understood why they were afraid. I understood the fact that they forgot how big their brand and not them as people was presents itself for the public. It was for Al-Nahar. They wanted to celebrate 80 years of existence. So here it goes. Oops. Thank you. So the client finally decided to be brave. And another just backstage story, this commercial was shot on iPhone entirely, because we discovered that there was an app on iPhone that will render those filters immediately. So it was the fastest used. Any idea about this one? Close enough. Be inventive. Why am I saying be inventive? Because today, technology is at the heart of communication. And if you follow your, if you follow the trends in advertising, you will realize that a lot of agencies and brands are relying on technology to send the message. I'm going to share with you an example that won a Grand Prix in Cannes. The video will speak for itself.
For thousands of years, people have used faces to tell stories. From portrait painting to emoticons of the present day, faces have always been a shorthand for communication. For the Sochi 2014 Winter Olympic Games, Megaphone launched the campaign Create Your Own Olympic History. It encouraged people to make the Olympics a very personal experience with social networks and Megaphone's mobile internet. Megaphone's Olympic Pavilion became the perfect culmination to the campaign. Its unique innovation was inspired by the notion of the selfie as a universal tool for communication in the digital age. And it became so much more. With the help of the world's first three-dimensionally actuated large-scale LED screen, thousands of people had a chance to create their own history at the Games. The gigantic facade of the pavilion is formed of 11,000 actuators. Each actuator carried their tip a translucent sphere that contains an RGB LED light. Each actuator acts as one pixel within the entire facade. It extends up to 2 meters to transform the surface in 3 dimensions. The resulting portraits appear inside of the building as big as 8 by 6 meters, a magnification of 3,500%. To create a selfie, the visitors simply scan their faces in one of the 7 instant 3D photo booths inside of the pavilion. The booths also travel to 30 cities in Russia to let everyone become the face of the Olympics. And live online video stream at the facade with the link to the personalized 20-second video. Make sure that no face will be missed. The ultimate selfie was hard not to notice. Epic. Innovative. The Megaphone's pavilion took social media by storm. And worldwide television and press coverage resulted in over $12 million of earned media. With Megaphone being the most talked about Olympic partner of the Games.
By being honest is always validate the uniqueness of the idea you're presenting to the client. Nowadays it's becoming more and more a challenge, a real challenge, to find ideas that are unique and that no other creative or agency have used anywhere else in the world. But despite this challenge, agencies are finding ways to inject unique concepts. Especially, for example, when it comes to outdoor. And this is a true example that won the Grand Prix in Cannes this year. It's for Apple.
These Apple billboards just changed. They're no longer ads, well, not traditional ads. They're photos, all taken with the iPhone 6.
world fame, all thanks to a cell phone picture.
How cool is it to see your photo on a billboard?
I have a big billboard that I just built right in Singapore.
One of my goals is to go to one of my billboards. I think there's one in New York.
Happier person. So the next one is, I missed it. It's Be Honest. No, it's the same, sorry. It's this one. It's this one. Not even close. Actually, it's a difficult one. It's Be Strategic. And this is a very important point because as creative people, we tend to give more attention to the idea, to the artistic side of the idea, and sometimes our enthusiasm makes us forget the golden rule that never changed. We create to sell. And it's very important that despite everything, we need to make sure that the message is actually pushing the selling aspect of the brand more than anything else. I have an example. Cars as a category is becoming more, you know, difficult when it comes to creating innovative ideas, especially for a particular category of cars. This is a nice example that made me smile. I hope it will make you smile. It's a unique idea. I don't know what the creatives were smoking when they actually created this idea. I don't even know what the client was smoking when he approved this idea. But I hope you will enjoy it.
Yeah.
And there are plenty of other examples like that, and most of them actually ended up winning awards. This is an easy one. Commandment number 7. Be trendy. And by be trendy, I mean don't just follow trends. You can, as advertisers, influence the public and create your own trends. There are plenty of examples. I can mention a couple of examples. In Lebanon, for example, you all remember slogans like Shufet Alei or like Mashiru Shadir. These are slogans that we used. They became part of our daily routine. And there is another example that actually impacted my generation that is still valid as an example, which is Budweiser.
Hello, hey, so, none of these watching game have a word, so the truth.
None of them watching game have a word.
True, true.
What's up?
Yo, what's
that?
Yo, you're picking the phone.
Hello?
What's up?
Yo!
Hello?
So what's up, dude? Watching the game, having a bird.
True.
True.
Two more to go. If you notice, there is no 3D rendering on this one, so the idea was be simple. And this is something that Simon already mentioned. So it's a simple fact that consumers love simplicity. Try not to overcomplicate ideas with a lot of thoughts and messages. It will only impress your mom, really. I wanted to show you an ad that is one of the most expensive ads. I don't know which agency did it. I'm not attacking anyone. But seriously, I couldn't understand the message. So if you can explain it to me, please be my guest.
So, you feel you're up for a challenge? Well, you might not play Ali Mabkut. Style of Atif Aslam.
Cool.
Or even announcing Leah Salonga.
And talk away.
You might add action to Sharon Butler. Funnier than Amin Helmis.
Hey, Amir, can I really mean how he said to me?
What's that?
That's just the lens.
Gosh, we love that.
Amir.
Or even outdoors, Hrithik Roshan. But we challenge you to find a mobile tariff in the UAE that Etisalat can't match or beat.
I can imagine the grief of the client is, I have $2 million to waste, how can you help me? Be insightful, and this is important. You need to know the market you're talking to. You need to know the language, you need to know the habits. I have two examples that are, for me, this is a campaign that actually I enjoyed working at in the last decade. It's called Chef Halak. I'm going to just show you two commercials that we did. I'm sure you
لكن شو فن ما انا من مزودت سيكورتان ما سيكورت انا خي ما بعطي اشارات انا بدي يدي اذا لقيت راكب على الشمال وانا على اليمين بشك السياره شك على اليمين بسوق محمد انا زلمه بسوق محمد طلع كيف ماشي ما في ابدا انا بتنشد السياره على نص السيح وضلني ماشي ليك العم كيف بسوق له
This is another example, more recent.
لو ما طلعش بدك تعرف ابو رصاص ملك السطوح والمناسبات السعيدة لما بتضم الزعيم هاي طلعة طلعة على الخفيف طلع الزعيم استنى بيخلص مش هتقدر تجيب
سمين لسه بيبدأ يقول إلى الإيقاع
يكون في حزن في إيقاع حزين بيجي أبو ضبر إجابة
بس
بس
يا
sponsor the news, but more to be in the news. And the example I want to show with you is about a brand that actually is year after year making the news.
Here's to the crazy ones. The misfits. The rebels. The troublemakers. The round pegs and the square holes. The ones who see things differently. They're not fond of rules, and they have no respect for the status quo. You can quote them, disagree with them, glorify or vilify them. But the only thing you can do is ignore them, because they change things. They push the human race forward. And while some may see them as the crazy ones, we see genius. Because the people who are crazy enough to think they can change the world are the ones who do.
Okay, 10 commandments. But there's just one more piece of advice before you graduate and join an agency. Love your brand. Don't ever consider that there is a small brief and a big brief. Don't ever consider that there is a small budget and a big budget. Every brief is a challenge in itself, and every brief is an opportunity for you and for your brand to shine. Thank you.